It's worth making the point that Victoria was very innovative in terms of its constitutional development, and that giving both men and women the right to vote took place here before it took place in England. It was a sign of the times, I think. Victoria was greatly of a democratic temper back in the 1850s in particular, and so was somewhat innovative in those years in those regards.